Buddy, your brain. Well, if you're like most people, you sometimes forget little things like name, or you walk into a room and you're standing there and say, what did I come in here for? You forget. Well, all of this is normal as we age. But what's not normal? And what can we do to keep our brain tuned up? June is Alzheimer's and Brain Awareness Month. And we've got a neurologist joining us right now. It's Dr. Sita Kedia, Chief Medical Officer at Palm Health. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
I got to tell you, I've been drinking that smart water. It's not helping. Have you seen that?
There's a lot more you can do.
Yeah. What are your thoughts, first of all, on stuff like smart water and supplements?
You know, I think that we're still learning a lot more about how different nutrients and supplements can help us. And so for us, we know that there's some that are really very, very widely accepted, things like omega-3 fatty acids, magnesium, even turmeric.
Mm-hmm. My wife is sharper than I, and that's because she does all those crossword puzzles. I swear by those.
Well, crossword puzzles are interesting. It's a really common question. So what we know is that we need to exercise our brain, and it's like our muscles. If we don't exercise our muscles, they slowly weaken and they become less strong. The same thing happens to our brain. So it's not really about the crossword puzzle, but it's really how do we strengthen those muscles of our brain. So giving it a new skill. I really like to promote individuals to try to learn a new hobby, such as sewing or knitting, or even picking up an instrument. Also, maybe even a language to really exercise that brain.
It goes, the coach used to say, if you don't use it, Pertzborn, you lose it. And that's true
exactly.
With your brain. Yeah. What about your food? What should we be eating for brain health?
You know, we really need to have a well-balanced diet. You know, we live in a society with a lot of excesses. So how do we limit those? Alcohol, carbohydrates, you know, those complex processed foods. And how do we limit those and also create a rainbow of colors when we eat, with each meal having the rainbow represented on our plate?
Let's touch on alcohol, because when you drink it, they always used to say, you know, you're going to kill all these brain cells in your brain. Are those cells replenished?
You know, we know that if we continue to exercise our brain and give it good nourishment, we're going to make those neuronal connections really much more stronger. We're still learning on how stem cells in our brain continue to regenerate over time. But, you know, giving excess alcohol, we know will degenerate the brain over time.
Oh, I had so many questions for you, doctor, but I forgot them all and we're out of time. But we do have a link to Palm Health. It's on fox2now.com. And also the Fox 2 mobile app. Remember, if you don't use it, you lose it. Thanks, Doc.